CBTC, or Communications-Based Train Control, is a new signaling system currently being installed throughout the New York City subway system. This new signaling system allows for trains to run closer together and would allow for the MTA to implement automation-type systems on board the trains. It's already been installed on lines like the L and 7, and is currently being installed on other lines like the Queens Boulevard line. On the lines where the installation is complete, service has dramatically improved, with trains running closer together and at higher speeds, speeding up commutes for daily riders. Now, it's time to install it on more lines throughout the system so we can see widespread improvements. In this video, I'll be talking about the lines I think CBTC should be installed on and what that would mean for the line. Be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel for more content like this in the future. Before we get into what lines CBTC should be installed on, let me explain to all of you just what CBTC actually is. CBTC is classified as a moving block cab signaling system. Basically, instead of having fixed blocks of, let's say, 1,000 feet, you would have a moving block with a buffer zone of maybe 50 feet. With this new moving block system, trains will be able to run closer together and continue to run at higher speeds. Now, I did mention cab signaling earlier. Basically, this system is able to run without those wayside signals you see throughout the system. This reduces the amount of maintenance the MTA needs to do on these signals and reduces the number of delays caused by said maintenance. This type of signaling system is used on many rail systems in the world. The London Underground, Singapore Metro, and even the Paris Metro all use some form of CBTC. So, now that you know the basics of CBTC, let's talk about the lines I think it should be installed on next. For the IRT or the A division, I think CBTC should be installed on the Lexington Avenue line, White Plains Road line, and Eastern Parkway line. Lexington Avenue local service currently runs at 18 trains per hour. While this seems reasonable, service levels can and should be increased along the line. Let's start with the facts. Lexington Avenue sees the most ridership out of any other subway line in the Western Hemisphere. With only 18 trains per hour, which we don't even see most of the time, you can be leaving some mildly wide gaps, and in that time, platforms can get extremely crowded. While a limiting factor of the capacity along Lexington Avenue is the City Hall Loop, we can increase service a bit, maybe up to 22 trains per hour. In addition to the service increase, we would also most likely see a reduce in delays caused by signaling issues. Now, the improvements don't stop with the 6 line, as both the 4 and 5 would benefit from CBTC on Lexington Avenue. While they run at a somewhat frequent 24 trains per hour, service can again be increased, possibly to 30 trains per hour, with both the 4 and 5 running 15 trains per hour. This would allow for 2-minute headways on the line, hopefully reducing crowding on the platforms and even the trains, as they would be more frequent. Of course, the increase in Lexington Avenue Line Express service relies on the White Plains Road and Eastern Parkway lines. There are 3 choke points on these lines. One at 149th Street Grand Concourse, which I've actually proposed a solution to. Another at East 180th Street. And another near Franklin Avenue at Rogers Junction. While CBTC wouldn't completely solve the issues at these choke points, it would hopefully reduce the delays caused at them, leading to faster service and more service. Moving on to the B division, where the bulk of the CBTC equipment is currently installed, I propose installing CBTC on the 6th Avenue line. Now, the MTA has already proposed installing CBTC on 6th Avenue, but it seems like they are trying to decide between CBTC on the whole line or just up to 47th Street. I think CBTC should be installed on the entire line. My reasoning behind this mostly falls on the express lines, the B and D. These lines run very infrequently. When only one is running, you can see headways of up to 15 minutes, and even when they both are running, the headways can still be as bad as every 10 minutes. That might not seem like much to many, but 6th Avenue, like Lexington, is a crowded line, and even a short delay in between trains can contribute to overcrowding on the platforms. I think CBTC is a solution to this issue, and as I must reiterate, it is not going to solve everything, but it will allow for trains to run faster, closer together, reduce the number of delays caused by signal problems, and more. Now for the A division, only the 3 and 6 lines would need new rolling stock. This is because they currently run R62 and R62As, which are incompatible with the CBTC systems. Now currently, the R142 and R142As are as well, but the MTA plans to make extensive modifications to both fleets to add CBTC and add new features like new traction motors, LCD screens, and more. There has been some talk in the MTA about doing the same to the R62 series, upgrading them to be compatible with CBTC for the time being, but I don't think it's worth it to do so. I think a better investment would just be to purchase the new R262 fleet. The R62 series is going to be retired somewhat soon, and I think it would be unwise to retrofit these train cars with CBTC systems if they're going to leave service not far into the future. For the B division, the B and D lines would need new rolling stock, and as I said in my R211 car assignments video, I would love to see the R160 and R211s on it. For my full thoughts on the car assignments on the B, D, 3, and 6 lines, I suggest you watch that video, along with my R262 video. CBTC, despite some of the issues the MTA has had with it, is the key to better service in New York City. While it would be possible to achieve 33 trains per hour with the interlining and normal fixed block signaling, particularly the type used on the IRT, we all know the MTA is not capable of making that happen. So, with CBTC, we can have a greater system, and I think we should start speeding up installation across the subway. If you enjoyed this video and you would like to get more from Mystic Transit, like, subscribe, and consider becoming a channel member.